This is the second video about the modifications and about changing the bench table saw on my mobile workbench. I swapped the Dewalt jobsite saw with a cast iron saw with an induction motor. Before moving on, I'd like to say that both saws work perfectly with this workbench, and that for DIY projects, each one has its own advantages and disadvantages. The main reason I decided to do this change is to show you how easy it is to adapt this design so that you can install a different type of table saw without the need to modify the bench frames. You only need to modify the worktables. A few days ago, I posted a video comparing both saws. If you're interested in watching it, you can find it on the playlist I created with all the mobile workbench videos in this channel. I'll post a link in the video description. The width of the bench remains the same after these modifications, around 180 centimeters. However, since the new saw is deeper than the Dewalt, the bench now has some added depth, about 68 centimeters to the work table, 74 centimeters if we're counting the fence. The saw's dust outlet doesn't let me close the outfeed folding table fully. I'm planning to change the outlet so that I can close it all the way and make it so the workbench takes up less space when up against the wall. I've also had to use a washer as a spacer to raise the outfeed table a little in the back. These kinds of folding shelf brackets always go down a bit more than you'd like in the back part, but thanks to this small modification, I've managed to solve this problem. This is the new hard birch plyboard with gray HPL sheets on both sides I've used to make the new work tables of the bench. These kinds of boards are a little expensive, but it's worth investing more in the part of the bench that is subject to more wear and tear when working. Besides its hardness, the outer HPL sheet with melamine makes the pieces slide better when working on the workbench. The position of the adjustable legs of the new bench saw has been determined. The work table juts out about 25 millimeters in the front of the bench. I made the plywood tops a little deeper so that they're in line with the saw's work table. Since this saw is less wide than the Dewalt, I've had to make a bigger work table for the router. The good thing about this mobile workbench meant for one of the biggest bench saws in the market is that now it will be easier to adapt to almost any kind of bench saw, even if it has a wheel to tilt the blade on the side. You can even install any saw as long as it's not over 35 centimeters high and 68 centimeters wide. I'm going to remove the router work table to see how I installed it. I used an L-shaped iron profile whose height I can adjust to attach the work table to the saw. Besides allowing me to even the two work tables, this L-shaped piece allows me to hold the saw and stop it from moving when working. I also made two other L-shaped plywood parts to achieve a bigger work surface, although I think for a hardboard like the one I used to make the work tables, this won't be necessary. In some parts, I had to use 0.5 mm thick PVC edge banding as a spacer to lift the tops a little and make them even with the rest of the workbench. Since you can change the height of the saw's legs, this design is almost completely adjustable and makes it easy to even out all the work tables. This is the work table I've been using for the router table. As you can plainly see, the new table is bigger. The idea now is to mill it so that I can place an insert plate to use the router, which I'll be showing in the next videos. I also remade the base and the top of the sliding carriage. Now both parts have melamine on both sides, and the carriage slides even better than before. Putting its fence in place is as easy as before, though I'm still planning to develop a system to make it square in a quicker and more convenient way. If someone has any good ideas to solve this, it would be a great help. You can leave your ideas in the comments. This carriage, along with the side folding table, will allow me to cut relatively big work pieces. I adapted the sled so that it can be used with this new saw. I have a video about the sled where I display all its possibilities. You can also find it on the Mobile Workbench playlist. Of course, with this new saw, I can continue using the miter gauge to make all sorts of cuts. I use the gap between the saw and the frame to store the rip fence. This way, I'll have it on hand all the time. With this setup, I can cut work pieces up to 88 centimeters. The blast gate box is now dedicated to the router table. A tube goes inside the gap that houses the router, and another goes directly to its fence. Now I'll show you how I finish the modifications. First off, prepare the L-shaped aluminum piece so you can bolt it to the saw top. I drill some holes and make them wider with a rasp so I can make height adjustments. Now I'll cut and machine the L-shaped plywood part for the back of the router tabletop. Also here I'm going to make the holes wider so I can adjust its height. I'm going to use biscuits and wood glue. I remove the old top and mark the position of the holes. I'll use hex lock bolts. Like I said, I'm going to change the sliding carriage base. This time I'll make this part a little bit wider than the last, so I'll have to cut part of the bench frame. I made a chamfer with a 45 degree bit on all edges of the HPL board. I marked the position of the miter channels and machined them with a table saw and a dado blade. Thank you. Now, following the same process, I'll make two rabbets so I can insert the T-tracks on the sliding carriage top. Since it's not very thick, besides wood screws, I'll use flathead bolts. For that, I had to thread some holes in the T-track. I'm going to make a quick adjustment before screwing in the sliders to the carriage top. Once that's done, I can screw them in as usual, with cyanoacrylate, washers, and wood screws. Now that I'm done modifying the sliding carriage, I'll use it to mark the correct height of the table saw. I'll use its adjustable legs to level it with the carriage. It's time to change the side folding table. I've screwed on two pieces of wood so I can hold the new top from below. This time I won't install T-tracks, that's optional. Now I'm going to install the top for the router. I have to make a rabbet to avoid the iron profile, as well as some non-through holes for the bolts. I drill the holes for the bolts that will hold the top and use them to mark the other holes in the iron profile and the bench frame. After threading the profile and placing the threaded inserts, I can make another dado for the miter channel and the T-track. All that's left now is to adjust the folding table in the back. I make some checks and it seems I'll have to raise the folding shelf brackets by a few millimeters. After making some dados so I can use all the accessories of the table saw, I can finally attach the top of this folding table with screws. Finally, I'll stick self-adhesive measuring tape on the table saw fence, and also screw on this simple piece to store the fence more comfortably. Thank you for watching this video till the end. See you soon.